Okay, just really quick. What did I do? I bought an angel feather. I bought another smelling salt. And I rested up at the inn, of course. It looks like I have a lot of money, but it's really... Stuff around here is expensive. I want to get her a Thornwhip. Pyra, that is. That's the only female member. I want to get her a wood shield as well. I want to get her a magic hood for defense. I feel like grinding for some of this stuff. I want to get Inigo an iron helm. And Madu, which I looked up, is actually a shield that also boosts your attack. And I want to get that for Milo as well. And I also want to get Inigo and Milo a long spear, which is almost $10,000. It's one of those deals. But what actually, it's probably only one of them. That's a weapon. That's a deal. Yeah. A bunch of these are special deals. Yes, I might not. I might have to choose who gets the Madu and who gets the wood shield. Is probably gonna be for Pyra. She can't use the Madu. I'm just gonna get her a Thorn Whip. What it does is attacks all enemies at once. So I just want to take a look at what she has here. So her armor factor is 77. Remember that. 77. She's actually not carrying any kind of a shield or anything like that. Which I'm surprised. A wood shield would be better than a bronze shield, but apparently it is. Oh no, we're boosting her weapon factor, 62. Just remember that, 62, because we have to sell her current weapon first. Well, she didn't have this very long, did she, the wood staff? No, I don't want to sell anything else. It's on the special deals. Which probably means there's only one of them then. Thorn Whip. You have barely enough for it. You better take it before I change my mind, he says. She was 62. Wait. I went past it. (laughs) 67. But it does damage to all enemies, or in a group anyway, for sure. So now we're like, well, not broke again, but we can't buy anything else. Even if we sold something, nope. So I've been writing down what I want to get them. So I can cross this out. Once I'm done with the Cave of Truth, I might just grind for the rest of this stuff. Because the next dungeon looks insane, and it's already getting insane. Alright, so I'll meet you guys back at the entrance to the Cave of Truth. Okay, back down into the chaos. Her whip is pretty awesome. Looking forward to you guys checking it out. Milo went up a level as we were making our way back through, getting to the entrance here. We're still gonna get a breath handed to us, I know. But on large groups, she rocks because she'll hit every member. That too. And then Milo finishes one off. Inigo's asleep. Wake up, Inigo! Of course, when we're fighting one enemy, she just hits it once, like normal. You gonna fight that thing? No? Okay, good. I guess once you defeat them, you defeat them. That's good news. Unless it's a random thing. Spinner, but we need to go forward. There we go. Three hits. Oh, was it? It looked like she hit one, and then hit a second one and got no damage, and she didn't attack the third? I'm not sure. It happened so fast. There we go. Inigo and Pyra could use a minor heal. I'll put it in D&D terms. Or cure light wounds, rather. Okay. Do I go this way? Up to this. That's a spinner, right? Yeah, okay. Of course, we need to go forward. It makes it a little bit easier. I mean, we haven't had one of those hellish battles yet. Hellish battle from hell, just yet. Sure, it's coming. Oh, the Psyblock, I remember him. Now, you know what's funny? That's an eye there, which I'm sure most of you are like, duh. But, you know, if you look at it real close, you see above the eye, and that little green thing, I guess that's its brow. But you look at the little green thing there. To me, those look like two tiny eyes. And the mouth, I mean the eye actually looks like a mouth with the red part of the eye, a tongue. So you get this thing, So it looks even funnier until I realize, oh yeah, that's an eye. You know, if you look at things a certain perspective, they look differently. Plus I still can't get over the Mickey Mouse shoes and the gloves. So this thing will just wail on it. And it missed, and it's probably gonna die now. Yay. Random save, where are we? think behind us is the... Yeah, we don't need to go that way. Which I am very glad about. Oh, no, again. I like these guys. They're not that tough, and they give out a good amount of experience. Because everything down this dungeon is giving good experience at this point. So now we couldn't barely hit the thing. Oh, tough monstrous ahead. We've been down here. Alright. So, to the left is a pool. To the right is nothing. To the next left is that D poison we picked up, and that's where we left off. D poison right ahead. Oh, boy. Let's see if she hits three. I believe she did. Better this time. Alright. That's the chest we opened. That's where we found our deep poison. So now we're continuing where we left off. Okay. I'm gonna go fight a ghost. I ain't afraid of no ghost. Ooh, what are you? Death rattle? Well, these guys tackle the lesser foes for now. Lunged at Milo. Only 1 point. Okay. Still able to one-shot it. It seemed we had a much harder time the last episode. Because now we're leveling up, so we're going to even be... more fearsome. So here, we're not going that way. We can actually go around that. Believe it or not. But for now, we're gonna... I mean, off the main hallway we just came from, we can go down there and go around it. This is a longer way around. But that's okay. I'll keep my mana, thank you very much. Down here is a dead end. We're gonna fight a ghosty. He's a ghosty. So we don't need any healing or anything like that? Oh, yeah, I guess Pyra? I'm playing it safe here, because she's not down that much, but I will play it safe. Because we are going to fight a ghost. I don't know how hard these things are. Ghost. No, I don't know. I don't know how tough these things are, so I'm gonna quicken Inigo. And I will try to slow the ghost. I'm pretty sure it's one ghost. I think. D-Soul. Milo falls lifeless to the ground? What? He's dead? Okay, I'm gonna be restoring that. Does it always do that? I'm gonna leave that closed. That thing kills us. Now, of course, we can go back to town and get him revived, but I don't want to go back to town right now. I just got here. I just made it a little further than we did last time. I'm pretty sure later on Milo gets a revival spell, but he does not have that yet, so let's leave the ghost alone, at least until then. I'm just gonna go all out on those toadstools. I hate those freaking things. Ah! At least two took damage. Alright, we're on. One of us is gonna fall asleep eventually. Ow! Damn, give him damage. Good, missing, I like it. Yeah, I didn't think that thing was gonna outright kill us like that. Cure light wounds for Inigo. Alright. Continuing on. We're gonna not go this way. And we're gonna kill this damn thing. This is only one. Goodbye. So yeah, if we make the left out of here, we will go the same direction and we'll be able to bypass that stuff. Nice, we affected all three. Ow. Oh! Heal itself, damn you! Oh, got a cloth head. Okay, we'll keep that. We'll sell that. It's very rare for these things to drop anything. So this is another way around, like I said. So you'll get your mana drained. You just gotta travel a little farther to get there, it's alright. Not that much farther. Milo, yeah. Where are we now? Around this corner? Oh boy, death rattles. Yeah, the Death Rattlers aren't that tough. I'm waiting for them to break out some kind of special attack. Otherwise, they're just doing one damage. Yeah, they're a lot scarier than they look, I guess. Yeah, we're good. Okay, I know where we are now. We're gonna pass by the mana draining crap right to our left. How likely will that do damage? Must always do damage. It's upon my order. Must do all the damage possible. Oh, you're still gonna die. So that's the mana passage that we made our way around. Up that little opening to the right there, according to the map I have here, it's a dead end and there's nothing there, so. Whether that's true or not. Oh, tomb walkers. How about thee? Much mad money. Are we over 2,000 already? Nice. Yeah, we can grind down here pretty effectively, as long as you don't fight ghosts. Leave the ghosts alone. There's another chest here with ghosts, so I'm gonna leave that one alone too. Oh, we're gonna have to fight this thing? Here we go. Let's quicken Pyra. Wonder if she can get off another attack with the whip? If anything, it's gonna help her defense. Unaffected. Damn it. He is attacking her. Of course, it's unfortunately. Oh, damn it. Before Milo got to cast his quick on her. Eam! I hope Pyra doesn't die here. Might not go first, so I'm gonna have her cast a heal on herself as well. Unfortunately, her heal is quite small, so. Okay, he's attacking Inigo, good. Okay, she's good now. You know what we need? A party-wide heal. That's what we need. I muddled it and it didn't seem to do anything. I guess it's a good thing she did that. Thank God. Cause damn. Now the good thing is, I think you only have to fight these things once. I did not mean to do that. Pyra still need one of. Yeah, Pyra can get by with a smaller heal. And Inigo. Pyra and Inigo. Actually, I will have Pyra cast that. And Pyra. She still has a lot of hit points. I mean, magic points. Okay. Well, there is a goodie up here. And we're gonna get it. An angel feather! That's it. Are we running out of space? I got two slots available. There's a big loop-de-loop in there. We don't need to concern ourselves with that. We'll just go right to the end. We'll get to the fight another one. Yeah, I didn't think that would work. Could use one of those awesome blows on these guys. Not a no damage thing. They weren't as tough as I thought. I think someone needs a healing now. Yeah, Pyra again. She's got a lot of magic points. Our resident spell powerhouse. It's just she needs more of these spells. Actually, she does have plenty. It's just not showing them all because we're not in combat. To fight another one? Are we ready for this? Caught by surprise, though. Maybe it's not one of these. Maybe this is just a regular pool. Which I want to remove one from the battle, is what it is. Just this is the part I'm not gonna like. Oh good. Pyra rocks now. Good, we didn't have to fight that one. I am happy about that. Okay. Now that place, that tunnel I passed that said it's a big loop-de-loop, comes out here, so. No need. No need for Tenshi. Let's see what's... is there anything here? Probably not. Yeah, didn't think so. Alright, we continue this way. Now this way, you can't see it, but up ahead are more mana-draining things. No real need to go that way. With this spinner here. One, two, three. I think this is a dead end, yeah. Nothing. Alright. Ooh! Dark wizards. Oh, they look like hags. What are they holding? Pink and white straw? Hey? No, I'm just gonna wail on them. Oh, one down. Oh, missed. Dead. So much for the dark wizards. One, two, three. Oh, going ahead, good. So this is actually a closed off section, but we want to go through here to get something. Unfortunately, we have to go through more of this mana draining crap. But not as much of it as we'd have to, because that continues up ahead. We want to take this left here. The next left is a dead end. All mana draining the whole way. And the left after that meets up to where we just saw where... that tunnel where I said you couldn't see it, but there's mana draining stuff over there. Yeah, so it goes around that way. So we do have to get a little... we should still have mana at the end of this. Hmm. False idol. That's a cloth head we found. Oh, yeah. Now we need this for the top. Something up top. I think to get to the last cave.